Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a quick look at the North American stock markets for Thursday morning. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are up across the board, so we are expecting to see some buying at the open at 9:30. Now, I know what the headline says. It was one of the biggest days in years yesterday to the upside, but it was still an inside day. And of course, that is because we've had tremendous volatility this week. And speaking of volatility, we had an inside day for the VIX for the S&P 500 and for the NASDAQ. There's the S&P 500 itself, the cash index, an inside day of an inside day. We still have an open gap to deal with. We still have Monday's high to deal with. And so it looks like we're going to open up near Monday's high at 1965.15. We still have an open gap there from Friday's low to Monday's high, a 5-point gap. That can act as an area of resistance as well. There's the Dow 30 inside day yesterday, Wilshire 5000 inside day. There's the NASDAQ, and the NASDAQ has been able to break out above Monday's high. And so people still love the technology stocks and still going back into those. But that's probably the brightest area of the market right now. Now, the NASDAQ still has something to deal with. It's taken out Monday's high, yes, but then it has an open gap up here from Thursday's low to Friday's high. And so that open gap could act as a potential magnet, could also act as an area of resistance. And making it up to that gap still does not give us a daily buy signal for the NASDAQ 100. Looking north of the border at the TSX has been able to trade into the gap that was created on Monday's open versus Friday's close. We've traded into that, haven't filled it yet. If we can get through that today, we still have another open gap from Thursday's low to Friday's high. And again, that could potentially act as a price magnet and an area of resistance. If we make it up to that point, remember our next price target up there is 13,750. So just above that open gap is our next mathematical price target. Looking at some other markets, money continued to come out of bonds on Wednesday. We saw money go back into the U.S. dollar. There's the NASDAQ 100 again. We were talking about the open gap. And just, if we go back and fill that open gap, that still doesn't give us a daily buy signal for the NASDAQ 100. Again, looking at some other markets, mid-cap, small-cap stocks not participating in the big rally yesterday. Yes, we were up, didn't take out the previous day's high, certainly didn't take out Monday's high. There's the Zacks micro-cap and inside day yesterday as well, and certainly not seeing as much interest in the small-cap, mid-cap stocks as we are in the big-cap stocks. And that, of course, is this is the risk-off trade when people are not going back into those stocks. So that reduces my confidence in this rally. It's a short-covering rally right now until proven differently. And certainly going into September and October, I don't think people want to be overly long going into two of the most volatile months of the year that also have a history of major market declines. There's U.S. bank stocks, another inside day of an inside day yesterday. Canadian bank stocks doing a lot better. The banks north of the border reporting record results this week. On a positive note, the wholesale price of gasoline continues to move lower. On a negative note, the price of gold continues to move lower, and we're sitting right on the edge of a new daily sell signal for the price of gold. Last up, quick look at a couple 60-minute charts. Yes, we're on an intraday buy signal for the S&P 500 coming into today's action. There's our mathematical targets, 1968.75 and then 2000. If you are day trading, then of course you've got your moving averages that you can use during the day as potential targets to the upside and areas of resistance. There's what it's going to take to get us back on a bullish note, is a breakout of that flypaper channel, which is continuing to move lower. And so I don't expect to see a breakout of the flypaper channel this week. Looking at the TSX, we're back on a buy signal going into the close yesterday. Again, there's our mathematical targets. First one is 13,437.50 and then 13,750. Of course, if you're day trading, we've got our moving averages that you can use, the 50, the 100, the 200-hour moving average as potential areas of resistance on the way up. And again, before we get overly bullish on the market, we're going to want to see the hourly charts start to break out above the flypaper channel. Not expecting to see that this week. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. It looks like a short covering rally to me. Yesterday's big up move certainly got a lot of people's attention, but mathematically speaking, it was still an inside day. We're still dealing with an inside week, and so we'll have to see what kind of follow through we get on Thursday and Friday. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again next on Friday morning.